presented by the Trent Redmond's Foundation and Second Story Interiors. Or while you're out to view tonight, stop by the silent auction display near Portal 8. The auction will close at the end of second intermission. The Detroit Red Wings Foundation 50-50 raffle presented by Michigan First Million Jackpot. Going by the minute, currently sitting at $7,343. Get your tickets from raffle volunteers and kiosks around the via until the end of second intermission. Your Detroit Red Wings and Little Caesars Arena are committed to creating a family-friendly environment where fans of both teams at all ages can enjoy every game. Please be respectful of fans around you by being aware of your language and by drinking responsibly. If someone in your area is not adhering to your code of conduct, please visit the guest services offices behind Portal 10 or 67 or speak to your usher. We also want to keep the players, coaches, and officials safe by prohibiting the throwing of objects onto the playing surface. Per the National Hockey League, throwing objects can result in a penalty being assessed for the home team. And for non-emergency attention from a Little Caesars Arena staff member, text LCA Help to 69050.
Experience at Little Caesars Arena and the District Detroit. With features that include real-time answers to your questions, mobile event tickets, and parking passes, express pickup for food and beverages, wayfinding, and much more. Head on over to the App Store or Google Play to download it today.
It should go well.
They're playing well, and now it's up to us and our team to show them that the Detroit is a company like it too. We want to beat them 100%, we want to beat them to the other members of the team, but in the NHL, so yeah, I'm so excited.
Matchup between these two teams. So that just tells you how far back they go. Montreal
Thank you very much.
He loves Dylan Larkin. So 7 points in his last 5 games. That's playing great.
Well, right, and that's what you were seeing this year, because he's really elevated his game and taken his team and will not be the guy. And we're talking about his run this before a couple of games ago, by the way. I'm sure he's not really good over the last periods against the Sharks either, where they had only 8 shots on net. Yeah, Montreal, this is a big game for them. They lost a tough game last night to New Jersey, 2-1. I'm sure a game they thought that they should have won. I mean, they're right there. They had the first wild card spot, but they're only 2 points ahead of the team that's just below them. And so it's, I think that Montreal is 4-5-1 in their last 10, and 2-3-1 in their last 5. So they've got to start cranking it out here, because sooner or later they're going to start to tumble a little bit, and it's going to become even pretty crazy then to get back into this thing.
Let's take a look at our players
to
watch tonight. It's Tyler Bertuzzi. He's got going in his last 2 games, and then Tomas Tatar will welcome back, welcoming him back to the Rangers Arena tonight, and he's been playing great this year.
Are we welcoming back?
He's on the
maybe not a nice welcome, right. But it's a welcome.
Yeah, he's got a nice job, obviously, for Montreal. I thought he had a nice job here for us. So good for him and Bertuzzi. You know, interesting to see Zadina on that line. I think that's a little grit to that line. You know, young player in the lineup. You know, we always take comfort in playing with guys like that. So I'm looking forward to watching both those guys eventually.
And another guy that's going to be talking to Max Domi,
the two
of the leading scorers for Montreal,
and
they're pretty
lethal up front. Right, well, Max Domi, you know, wasn't working out in Arizona, and, you know, they moved him. A little slow start here in Montreal, but obviously now 54 points, 20 goals scored, 34 assists. He started to come on and start to be a leader, and, you know, much like his dad, a little different player than Ty Domi, obviously. Just a little bit. But, yeah, but he, you know, he's a pretty physical, he can rough and tumble if you want. But yeah, you know, he's more offensive minded, and his game's starting to come together. Should be a good matchup. And I know Ty was from Windsor, so I'm not sure if he has family here in the area, but well, he's probably pretty psyched to be close to, you know, where at least his family is.
Alright guys, yes, we are very excited for tonight's matchup. But fans, we're going to sign it over to an interview that I actually did a little bit earlier with Eric Reiner, one of our ticketing.